tutorial, I'm going to talk about the self-referential structures or list. Let us define a structure with a member field that points at the same structure type. We wish to do this in order to have an unspecified number of such structures nested together. We define a structure named list with two elements. One is an integer data, and the another one is a pointed next member, which is of type structure list. It means that structure is the same as this one, and next has the same elements. This declaration can be stored in two words of memory. The first word stores the member data, and the second word stores the member next. The pointer variable next is called a link. Each structure is linked to a succeeding structure by way of the member next. These structures are conveniently displayed pictorially with links shown as arrow. And the structure list look like so. Data has a part of memory, and thereafter, because it is a structure, thereafter is a memory is taken by next, which is a pointer, and it pointing to somewhere in memory. The pointer variable next contains either an address of the location in memory of the successor list element or the special value null, defined as zero. Null is used to denote the end of the list. Let us see how all this works by manipulating. We are defining three variables of type structure list ABC. We will perform some assignments of these structures, and we are going to, because the list has two elements, integer data and a pointer of structure list, of the type of structure list. A of data we are initializing as 1, B of data initializing as 2, C of data we initializing as 3, and we are going to initialize A of next, B of next, C of next as null. And it's going by this declaration and the initialization, we are going to get structure A, structure B, structure C. The first member has been initialized 1, 2, 3, and the second member are null. And all of them are a structure. But we can chain these structure together by using A data, A next, A of next is equal to what is in address B, and B of next is equal to what is in address C. This pointer assignment results in linking linking A to B and to C thereafter. After chaining our link look like so. A the next a of next, which is null, pointing to address B, and B of next, which is null, is pointing to address C. Now the links allow us to retrieve data from successive elements. Thus, A of next of data, because next is pointer, we cannot use a dot next dot data, because next is a pointer defined in our structure. Next is a pointer of type structure list, and when we want to come to its member, to its member which is pointing, then we are going to use the pile. A dot next pile data has a value 2. This is A of next pointed or pile 2 data. It is 2. And A of next pile data, pile data is 3, because the next in A is piling to B, and the next in B pointing to 3, to C. And we can use B dot next pile data is 3, but if we want begin from the beginning of the link or list, we can use A dot next pile dot a pile and next pile data is 3. Okay, what we need in link or list is a storage allocation. In header file stdlib.h, we find function like malloc and calloc. With malloc of size, it returns a pointer to enough storage for an object of size bytes. The storage is not initialized because we don't know how many spaces in memory and a link, a list, or a structure is going to take. We are going to use a malloc of size that it takes, that it occupies and reserve and a storage in the memory with correct items of bytes. The argument to malloc is of type z size t. The argument is of size t, and the value return is of type pointer to void. Recall that the size t is the unsigned integer type that is defined in both stdef.h and stdlib.h. It is the type that results when the size of operator is used. If head is a variable of type link, which is a list or structure. Then we are going to use head equal malloc size of element, which is a pointer like a link or struct or structure. Obtains a piece of memory from the system at equate to store an element and assigns, which is a structure, and assigns its address to the pointer head. It gives a memory allocation. As in the example, malloc is used with size of operator. A cast in is unnecessary because malloc returns a pointer to void, which can be assigned to a variable of any pointer type. The size of operator calculates the required number of bytes for the particular data structure. In the code that in the following code, we will dynamically create a linear linked list storing the three characters N, E, and W. The code is head, if we have defined the element of a structure list, we are going to define another structure called head, and we are going to allocate memory for head, and that is because we are going to use head equal malloc size of that structure element. And because head is a pointer, it must be a pointer, we are going to use head pile D, which is it's one of elements, is equal a character N, and head pile next we are putting it as null. Then we can see a single link or list. Head has the first element N and the next element is null. A second element is added by the assignments is head pile next is equal malloc size of element. Then we are going to that one, head next, we are going to allocating the same memory spaces, and we are going to use head pile next pile D is E, and head pile next is null. And the two element linked list look like so by this definition. And we have the first element in the link has a character N, and the second element, which is a structure next called next, it pointed on the next element in the list, which we have defined its character, the first element, as character E, and the next element null. Now we are going to finally declare another head next allocate another space in storage in memory, and we are going to initialize the header next D is W, and it's next head next is null, and we are going to get three element linked list. The first element, second element, and the last element, which its next is null and means that the list has only three element and it stops here. Okay, let's run a program. As I explained before, we can instead of we write all those functions and structures and linking, we are and put it in the original main .c program. We are going to use another program. We are going to gather all those things in another program and call it list.h, and it is our local header file. It is our local header file. It is not the library header file, but we are going to define our local header file, and we are going to include that local header file. And in this .c, in this program, we are going to declare a function of type structure with one character as a parameter, and we are going to use another function print list with parameter as a structure, and we are going to count the member of the link or list, and inside the void we are going to declare another variable of type link, which is a structure, and we are going to call string to list abc, and we are going to print the resulting list, and we are going to call print list of h, which is the link of a type link as we have declared here, and we are going to print the number of elements in the list by calling the function count link, count structure. What is happening in list H? We are going to include stdio, include stdlib for malloc and calloc, and include assert to check something that variable is not out of bounds, and we are going to use a local macro variable of type char by using type definition char data. Data is going to be a local macro variable of type char. We are going to define structure linked list with two elements, The first one, variable D of type data, which is a character, and we are going to the next element is the same. It is a pointer of an structure of the same structure we have. It is recursive. And we are going to use type definition struct linked list element, and we are going to define element pointed link. Another pointer of that structure. Now we are going to use link, because link has been as a local global variable of type structure, and we are going to use define an function of type structure link with parameter a character s, array of character s, and inside that function we are going to declare another structure head of type link, because link is a pointer, head is going automatically a pointer, and we are going to use if the first character in S is the end, is null pointer, then return null, which means that we haven't any character. Otherwise, we are going to use head. We allocate a space for head, malloc size of element, which is the size of structure linked list, and because head is a structure of type is a pointer structure of linked list, and they have two variables, two elements. The first one is D, and then second one is pointed next, and we are going to, because head is pointer, we are going to use head pile D equal S of 0, and head of next we call again this function a string to list, but next element is in character S, because S is an array of character, it is a pointer, and you are allowed to use S plus 1 instead of using S of 1. You are going to use S plus 1, and we are going to return, because the function is of the type structure and head is a structure, we are going to return head, which is a structure. The second one, we can use, it was list creation using recursion. If we want create list using iteration, we are going to use a function S to L, and with the parameter a array of character S, and the whole function is of the type link, of the type structure, and inside the function, we are going to declare another identifier or a structure head of type link, and we are going to initialize head as null, and we are going to define another structure tail, and we are going to declare an integer variable I. And we are going, instead of here we used if s equal to null, but we are going to use if s is not equal to the end of the string, then we are going to allocate head with size of element and head of D is S0, and we are going to put the head in the tail, and we are going to make a loop for I from 1, because S of the first element is S is used. Then we are going to start our for loop with 1, and SI is not in the end of the string, and we are going to increment while is not the end of the string. We are going to use tail of next. We are going to allocate a memory and a storage in memory, and we are going to put in tail next, that one we are going to put it, and we are going to use tail D equal S E ith element in S. Instead of using tail next D, tail next of D, we are going to put the tail next in this one to call the its first element. Otherwise, we cannot use the loop. And after the loop, we are going to put tail next. After that, when we have reached in the end of the string, and we have put the last element in the link, we have initialized its first element as SI and its next element as null, means that our link is finished. And we are going to return head, which is the structure. I suppose that I must return tail, not head. I must return tail. Now we can count a list recursively. We are going to make a function of type integer and call it count, and we have the parameter is of the type structure link, as we have defined up there. And if head equal null, return 0, else return 1 plus, and call the function again, count head of next. we are going to, if we want count a list iteratively, we are going to use count it with the parameter structure, and we are going to declare a count equals 0 of the type integer, and we are going to make a for loop without any start, and we are going to tell if head is for loop, it hasn't any start, and it's going while head is not null, and we are going each step put head equal head of next, and we are going to increment cnt and return cnt, which is an integer, and the function count it is a type of integer and must have a return. Now print a list recursively. We are going to use a void print list with parameter structure, and if head is null, printf null, else printf a character with pile, and use the head of d, which is the it was character, and print list again. We are going to call the same function head of next. If we want concatenate two lists as a head, we are going to have a function concatenate link A, link B. Both A and B are a structure of the type link, and we are going to use assert here if assert is not null. Then you are going to use that if else function or statement A of next equal, if A of next equal null A, that means that we are in the end of list A. If we are in the end of list A, then use A of next equal B, else if it is not null, concatenate a of next with b, which is we are calling again the function. Generating recursion. What we are doing here? We are going to check if the head or list is null, do nothing, else do nothing, but use generating recursion head of next, and it is going to do this one until we are going to the end of the head, the end of the list. Recursion deletion of a list. We are going to have a void delete list with a parameter of structure. If head is not null, delete list head of next. We are going to call again the list of the head of next, and we are going to use three. After that, we are going to use three head. It means that if your list has a variable here, we are going to delete it, and we are going to free, and we are going to call the delete again, and we are going to see it's next. If it is not null, we are going to delete the next and the next and the next until we are going to reach the null, to the end of list, and we are going to free the list of those deleted members. Now we are going to run, compile. It is a warning. It is a warning. We don't need initialize anything, and it is a warning. An infinite loop, and it is okay. But I am going to run this program. Yes, we have called function string to list, which has a parameter, array of characters, and it calls a string, and I have put it ABC, and I have print the resulting list is, and I have called a print list of H, and I am going to print the number of elements in that list make it. The list is A, B, C, and the end is null. The list has three elements, A, B, C. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.